The first intercity car flight, a wingless aircraft with a UFO-like appearance, and a million-dollar car that can't fly due to regulations. These are the topics you'll discover in our video about flying cars of the future that already exist today. We'll delve into the technologies used for flight and the laws regulating such vehicles. Enjoy the show! Types of technologies. The technologies used in creating flying cars bear strong resemblance to modern aviation. As always, the primary challenge revolves around the weight of the technology itself. Building a flying apparatus is a constant race to reduce weight, because lower weight makes takeoff easier. That's why the structure of such vehicles closely resembles that of airplanes and is crafted from durable yet lightweight materials. Flying cars are primarily powered by internal combustion engines and propeller blades. Why internal combustion engines? It's due to the size of these vehicles. Installing a jet engine in a regular car would pose placement challenges. Moreover, jet engines have low efficiency, which doesn't align well with the concept of small, economical flying cars. In terms of takeoff methods, flying cars can be categorized into helicopter type and airplane type. Some cars can ascend into the sky right from a standstill, while others require a runway for takeoff. But enough about the technologies. Next, you'll learn about the options that you can already acquire today. AeroMobil. The Slovakian company AeroMobil has been diligently working on creating a flying car since 1990. Multiple prototypes were developed and numerous tests were conducted. The car successfully passed its tests in 2016. AeroMobil runs on gasoline and performs excellently on regular highways. It only needs a flat 650-foot runway for takeoff and a mere 160 feet for landing. The car can land not only on perfectly smooth asphalt, but also on unpaved surfaces. It can achieve a flying speed of 120 miles per hour and a highway speed of 110 miles per hour. Of course, the cost of this car is very high. The reason is that AeroMobil is not mass-produced. Each model is custom-made. Therefore, you would need to shell out around 300,000 euros to purchase one. While this amount could buy a helicopter or an airplane, they can't navigate highways. The next option is far more futuristic and impressive in its features. Terrafugia Transition. Terrafugia Transition is a real car that can fly. Its standout feature is its foldable structure, allowing it to be easily stored in a garage. Additionally, it comes equipped with autopilot. You don't even need to be a pilot to operate such a vehicle. The developer has equipped it with two electric motors and the same number of wings, which can assume two positions – horizontal for takeoff preparation and vertical for ground movement. It also boasts a 300-horsepower internal combustion engine. Thanks to additional propellers and a tail fan, this flying car can take off and land without the need for a runway. It doesn't require a traditional airstrip. The maximum speed is also impressive – 200 miles per hour, comparable to modern sports cars and light aircraft. It can cover a distance of 500 miles. Anyone with a driver's license and the completion of a pilot training course can drive and fly this car. The price for this option is high, but lower than that of the AeroMobil. In 2025, when serial production is planned, the cost is expected to reach 279,000 euros, and it may decrease further. Moller Skycar M400. Another intriguing option is the Moller Skycar M400. Interestingly, you can purchase this flying apparatus right now, although the price is sky high. It's listed on eBay for $1 million. The price is indeed astronomical, but justified. The vehicle can vertically take off and land, and it boasts an incredible maximum speed of 380 miles per hour. Its flying range is comparable to modern airplanes, reaching 900 miles. Moreover, its fuel consumption is quite economical, just 8.5 liters of gasoline per 62 miles, similar to modern cars. The car can accommodate up to 4 people, and considering its flight speed, you can travel from London to Madrid in just a couple of hours. The project has already attracted $80 million in investment. Many major companies are interested in the project and want to establish mass production under their own brand. Therefore, in the near future, we may see numerous flying cars in the skies. Certainly, such projects will be very beneficial for society. But in today's bureaucratic world, there are questions about regulating this type of transport. Who will be held responsible in case of an aerial accident? And under which laws will the owner of such a vehicle be accountable? Laws and regulations. All issues related to laws are currently seriously restricting the use of such vehicles. When in the air, these flying vehicles operate under the laws applicable to airplanes and helicopters, while on the road, they must adhere to automobile laws. As you've probably gathered, this raises numerous questions about who's right and who's at fault. Projects like these are currently facing restrictions. Take the Moller Skycar M400, which as a reminder costs $1 million. It simply can't take to the skies due to regulations. You might spend a fortune on a cool futuristic flying car, but you won't be able to soar into the sky because the bureaucrats at the Federal Aviation Administration in America just can't figure out whether it's an aircraft or an automobile. These issues are currently imposing significant limitations on the use of flying cars in our reality. But all these complexities can be overcome, even though it will take some time. In 2021, the Terrafugia flying car received approval from the FAA, bringing it one step closer to the desired status of the first such vehicle authorized for real-world use. This will require the pilot to have both a flight license and a driver's license. As for other countries, it's a big question mark. In Europe and America, general aviation is well developed, whereas Russia faces significant challenges. Simply flying between cities in the world's largest country requires submitting a flight plan down to the minute, maintaining constant communication with air traffic controllers, and strictly adhering to the route. Any deviation must be approved. In contrast, in Europe you can fly between cities and countries without elaborate plans. There's also the issue of vehicle inspections, which are very stringent in aviation while they are relatively straightforward for automobiles. All these questions are still awaiting resolution. Next, you'll hear about the most interesting concepts of flying cars whose appearance is truly mind-blowing. AirCar. AirCar is a sports car that made the world's first intercity flight. Behind the wheel and at the same time in the cockpit of this flying transformer was its creator, Stefan Klein. He drove the aero car to the runway of the International Airport in Nitra, where the car took off and after 35 minutes successfully landed at Bratislava Airport, from where Stefan proceeded to the city center. The car's appearance is worth noting as well. It looks like a cool sports car. In its folded state, you'd never guess that this machine can fly in the sky rather than on public roads. Klein spent over 20 years developing the flying car. The model underwent more than 140 test flights. The wings and tail of this twin-engine air vehicle can be extended or folded with the press of a button. It has a cruising speed of about 120 miles per hour, a flying altitude of around 8,200 feet, and is powered by two BMW engines. It is expected that the next version of AirCar will have a maximum cruising speed of 180 miles per hour. Among its advantages, the model allows not only flying, but also serving as a regular car in city streets. Among the disadvantages, AirCar cannot take off and land vertically, uses gasoline engines instead of electric ones, and drivers will need both a pilot's license and a driver's license. However, this drawback probably applies to all flying cars. PAL V Liberty. The PAL V Liberty is a flying tricycle for two. The Dutch company PAL V has been working on developing this model since the early 2000s. Already in 2009, a prototype under the provisional name X1 was tested. More recently, in the autumn of 2020, the new PAL V Liberty successfully passed tests for compliance with technical and environmental requirements and received official approval for road use. The final step towards mass production and entering the market will be its planned certification in 2022 by the European Union Aviation Safety Agency. PAL V Liberty is a two-seater gyroplane with one pusher propeller and one rotor working in autorotation mode. It can take off and land at speeds of around 30 miles per hour. This allows it to use roads and regular landing areas rather than specially prepared airstrips. The flying car is powered by a 100-horsepower aviation engine, and its torque is transmitted to the rear wheels. The maximum speed on the road is 100 miles per hour, and it can accelerate from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 9 seconds. The tricycle's stability is ensured by electronics that tilt it in turns. For flying, an additional 100-horsepower engine is added to PAL V Liberty, which is deactivated on the road to avoid increasing carbon dioxide emissions. The flying range is 250 to 300 miles, while it can travel much farther on the road, up to 838 miles. The estimated cost of this flying car is €299,000. Xpeng HT Aero. The Chinese aero car Xpeng HT Aero may enter production as early as 2024. The vehicle will be electric and capable of both road and air travel. The aero car features a lightweight body design with aerodynamic shapes. In flight mode, special extendable elements with rotors at the ends are deployed on the sides, allowing the vehicle to take off and land vertically. However, it's hard to believe that it will go into mass production in 2024, as we haven't seen any tests or working prototypes yet. Cyclocar. The Cyclocar is an AeroMobil designed to accommodate up to 6 people, and development efforts have been underway for quite some time. As mentioned earlier, the vehicle will feature boarding options from both the sides and the rear. The Cyclocar has compact dimensions measuring 20 by 20 feet, with a maximum speed of 150 miles per hour and a flight range of up to 310 miles. In addition to its compact size compared to helicopter technology, a distinctive feature of the vehicle is its ability to land on sloping surfaces. Manufacturers emphasize that a notable feature of this innovation is peripheral protection, which prevents individuals from coming into contact with rotating blades while safeguarding the blades from foreign objects. Furthermore, the company assures that operating the Cyclocar will be no more complicated than driving a regular car. It can be piloted by an onboard operator, controlled remotely via the model's communication system, or managed from a ground control point as a full-fledged drone. The pilot operator will essentially perform directional control, issuing commands related to direction and speed to the automatic control system while maintaining necessary oversight. FLYTER. However, we've saved the most intriguing option for last. FLYTER is a wheelless and wingless aero car. Its appearance is truly mind-boggling, since it's hard to fathom how this capsule will fly. Flight testing of the first prototype began in the summer of 2021. As of today, the vehicle can fly for 20 minutes, but the developers envision it being able to hover for at least an hour in the future. The company has obtained patents for the industrial design, the FLYTER trademark, and is currently seeking patent registration for the innovative electric motor for the aircraft. FLYTER has a drop-shaped design with no wings, and it ascends into the air with the help of 16 propellers that retract into recesses in the body. The AeroMobil exhibits a maneuvering accuracy of 0.6 feet during takeoff and landing. Its operational temperature range spans from -4 to 104 degrees Fahrenheit. The maximum flight range is 93 miles with a speed of up to 75 miles per hour. The vehicle comfortably accommodates 2 passengers along with luggage. It operates on electricity, ensuring no carbon dioxide emissions. Additionally, the innovation features an operational system that includes an autopilot system, passenger interaction system, including a voice assistant, and interaction systems with third-party services. Perspectives. The prospects for flying cars are enormous. Right now, general aviation is highly popular in many countries, offering an easy and rapid way to cover long distances between cities. However, airplanes and helicopters come with significant drawbacks. You can't easily reach the city center from your airstrip. Flying cars address this problem because you can either land on an airstrip and then drive to the city center or land directly in the city. The combination of a car and an aircraft is highly functional and practical, which is why many investors see it as the future and are investing substantial sums in development. So all that remains is to await the mass production of these exciting vehicles.